Hey guys, it's Lydia here, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how I make this into this. So, let's get started. Okay, so, I know I've been gone for a long time, and I probably should be using this time wisely, because the coronavirus is taking over everybody's schooling system. So, right now, school is closed, and I should be making videos for you guys. I've just been busy making signs off of camera. But I want to know what you guys think about this video, if you want me to show you how I make other signs other than these circular signs, these circular custom signs. I actually really enjoyed making this. It was a quick video for you guys, but I just wanted to show you guys how I did it. So let's get right into the video, and then I'll talk a little bit more at the end. Alright, so starting off, I just bought a 15-inch round edge glued pine at Menards. I just figured this would be way easier than making my own circle out of pallets. And then I just did like a gray wash kind of stain on it. It's paint, but it's watered down. And so it just gives this a nice look, so you can still see the wood grain, but you get that color. So then I just go in and sand it with 220 grit just to make sure everything's smooth, and just give it a little bit of rustic wear look. And then I give it about 2 coats of polycrylic just to give it that nice matte look before putting the letters on. And then I'm using plywood here for the letters. And instead of having them chip out, I wanted to make sure that I got a lot of polyurethane coated on it just to get everything sealed up and nice and compressed in there. And then I added some of this masking tape over it just to also try prevent a little bit more, because I didn't have a down cut bit at this time, which I did now order one for this. And then I cut them out on my CNC, but unfortunately the family part of the words did have a lot of chip out, so I cut that out of pine instead. But the bigger letters are cut out of the plywood. And now you can see I did my tape method so that I could airbrush. Now, unfortunately, my airbrush was acting up, and when I use white paint on plywood, it doesn't coat very well with the airbrush. So I actually did end up hand painting these, and they did turn out pretty nice in the end result, even though I thought they would have brush strokes. But because of the letters were so small, I just ended up doing, instead of airbrush, just brushing it by hand, and it looks really nice. And then I just started adding the letters on the front, and I did add this little piece on the back because I was going to engrave something, but I messed up, so it's just kind of there instead of putting the little rubber stops on the back in the end. And I just used some clear Gorilla Glue non-foaming to glue up the letters, and once again, without the down cut bit, there was a little fraying on the letters, so I did have to use an X-Acto knife to cut them off, but this is the end result. And I think it came out really nice and clean, and I really like the choice of colors that was picked by the client. It looks really nice and clean.
Okay, so that is it for the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I know it was short and sweet, but one thing I did mention was coating the sign with polycrylic. I know that was a really fast clip, but I did also finish the sign with polycrylic because it will be an indoor sign instead of finishing it with polyurethane, because as you guys know, I've mentioned before, polyurethane turns white paint yellow. So I just bought a couple cans of polycrylic for projects like this, but this was a simple project. I believe it cost me about $15 to make, and I believe I start the price at $75 because of all the labor and stuff it takes. It really doesn't take that long. But then when I multiply the company profit by it and stuff like that. So these signs are actually super nice, and because they're custom, once again, they will be a little bit more. I do range my pricing for hour of labor a little bit different than I would for a normal, say, quoted sign. But I think this turned out really nice. Let me know what you guys think about it, if you guys like these little signs, if you like my voiceovers. I know I've been doing mostly time lapses. It's just easier for me to do for filming because I am alone. I am doing these videos all by myself, but I hope you enjoyed it. Once again, let me know down below what you think in the comments. Give me any tips and tricks, but I will have more videos coming to you guys because I've been filming a little bit. I just haven't been getting to editing, so hopefully I will be getting to editing the videos and uploading them for you guys because of this whole corona thing. So I am stuck inside, and I actually did go to Menards and Home Depot to buy a bunch of lumber to get ready to stay home for a long time to make lots of signs. And I actually am making a video for you guys about finger joiners. If you do follow my Instagram, I will have that link down below. I have been posting updates on what I've been doing, and the signs that I've been making with the finger joiner bits look really cool and very unique. So thank you so much for watching. I'm going to stop rambling on and let you guys go. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.